Hi, John here. This video is going to be an update on a month's worth of our Vaillant 7 kilowatt heat pump, air source heat pump. How's it been? How's it been performing? What problems have we had? And we've had a few minor problems, so I want to talk to you through those and how we are resolving those. And so it's just really a bit of an update video. The installation was finished in July, so I'm a bit late with this monthly update, so this data covers most of August. We haven't had the heating on. We've just been running the domestic hot water runs. We have had the heating on a bit since then, so I'll cover that a bit towards the end of the video. In the back end of September, there was a cold week where 2 or 3 days we had the heating on. But primarily, it's this first month that I'm covering and what we've discovered and how it's been performing. I'm not going to go through all the detail of the installation. That's covered in a previous video. So if you'd like to have a look at that, then I'll put a link to that up in the top corner, and it'll be down in the description as well. So please feel free to go and have a look at that. Overall, installation's been really, really good. Mark from JMR Heating and Energy has been back a couple of times to sort a few things out. Nothing major. Again, a lot of that was detailed in the previous video. One of those is taking out the buffer tank. That was probably the major change. I've been working through learning about the heat pump. We do get a lot of information. It's not like a gas boiler where they just chuck it in and you get one manual. There is quite a bit to learn. And you've got two schools of thought. You can either set it and forget it, or I much prefer to understand how it's working, what's working well, what's not working so well, how to optimize the system, what the controls are, what triggers it to start, to stop, all of that kind of thing. So the more I learn about it, the better. So in terms of the controls, we have this Senso comfort control, which is a bit like a room thermostat in primarily use for most customers. Again, it's sort of set it, forget it. You set your room temperature and whatever you want. Desired temperature, here it tells you what the current room temperature is, and time, humidity, or the outdoor temperature is as well. You can get a bit of information from that in terms of current temperatures, which is in the menu. And you also have an app. There's the Sanyo app over down the bottom, on the bottom screen there, bottom line. And also the Ebon CMS app, which I'll be coming back to. That's the open energy monitoring, because I've been using both of them. The Sanyo app is okay, but it's very sort of top level. If you want to drill into the detail and find out all the data, then this really isn't the app for you. This has been always being replaced by a newer version of the app, the MyVaillant app, but people have been migrated from this Senso app across to that, but I haven't had the invite for that yet to upgrade. So I can only talk about this one. When you open it up, it'll give you this information in terms of, tells you what's on and off and current temperatures, etc. And then if you click into the detail, it'll tell you the temperatures of the hot water, the humidity, and the temperature of the central heating circuit. If you want to go in detail, there's loads of charts up here. I'll just scroll up to those up here. So electrical consumption, blah, 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 you can read there. And you can go into those and get daily, weekly, monthly, annual stats. And it's sort of top line stuff. Obviously, we haven't had ours running very long, so there's not actually that much data to report on. And you can see there that it's pretty scant in terms of what it gives you, just running totals. So that's okay, but it doesn't really tell me how much and how efficient it is. You can't get the coefficient of performance figure from that. So you can get that from this device here, which is the control unit. And if you go into the screens, into the menu, so this is for the month of August. So our COP for our domestic hot water in August was 3.6. Total since installation is 3.4. So that's okay for top line figures, and you can get similar information from the sensor comfort app by going into the consumption field here. So you've got heating, domestic hot water, cooling, and the overall installation. I haven't got cooling configured on mine. So heating gives you totals. Same with domestic hot water. Cooling, see blank. Overall installation, so as general electrical consumption of the motor and stuff like that. Compressor, and then the environmental yield. And there's the temperatures I was talking about. So what current flow temperature is, and what temperature of the hot water is. And there again, you can see that again in the Sanyo app. And it corresponds nicely to what the eddi temperature is, so you know they are accurate. And I took some solace from this in terms of the accuracy, because we were having issues with the open energy monitoring and it was giving us very erroneous data. Just to refresh you briefly on this, the two primary inlets here, 35 mil flow and returns from the heat pump coming into the loft, going round pressure relief vessel. There's the three port valve swapping between heating and domestic hot water. This is the heat meter installed on the return flow, and that's got a pocket sensor built into it. That's the return temperature sensor. That's the low temperature sensor. So that's the setup. I was saying that we were having reporting problems with the open energy monitoring. Well, it was more the heat meter rather than the open energy monitoring. The open energy monitoring that identified that there was an issue with the heat meter. So you can see here, this is from installation through to the end of September. You can see there, right on the far right hand side, Friday the 22nd of September, we had a copper 5.5, which was very impressive. But let's skip to the left hand side where we have the problem. So for instance, 21st of August there on the Monday, we've got a cop of 1.7. And if we drill into that day, which I've done here, just highlight it to expand it. And we can see that the blue line indicates the flow rate. So it starts off 1.8 litres a minute. It then rises to 20, and then it does bounce backwards and forwards. You can see there's lots of cycling. Through discussion with people who know a lot more about this than me, identified that it's most likely air trapped in the system that's causing that. So the Camstrom heat meter works on sending ultrasound across a sensor. So if there's air in there, then that causes problems with it. And that's what we see that here with those peaks and troughs, or little cycling as it's called. We know that the air source heat pump is working efficiently because we've seen the COP figures from the controller unit at, for the month at 3.6. Whereas here, this particular window is showing a COP of 1.14. So it led to believe that there was a problem with air in the system. And if we looked at, for instance, a heating cycle, this is a heating cycle running from about midnight through to 6 in the morning. And you can see the flow rate is very consistent, typically around 20 litres a minute, which is perfect. And a nice delta T between the flow and return, so 50 and 43 between 5 and 7, which is exactly what you would expect for good performance. So we worked out that there's probably still air trapped in the system, and these AAVs, automatic air valves, are designed to bleed the air out. This one should have a little black cap on the top of it. Now here's two more that Mark installed. These are on the primary flow and return up in the loft on the highest point. You can see he's raised these so that the highest part of the pipe work. These have been actually working really well. I've been able to get rid of a lot of the air that was trapped in the system, and they're on a nice straight run. I've also then been going around, once we're running the heating and domestic hot water, flipping backwards and forwards, trying to push the air around the system, and going around the radiators bleeding them. I did them all initially, and there was only two that suffered from lots of trapped air. So I go and done the whole radiators twice. But again, it's these two that are the ones that seem to trap all of the air. So I've been daily going round and bleeding those, getting out loads of air. If we look later, since running those, you'll see here the performances are a lot better. Some of these figures here are with heating as well, which improves the COP. So 4.6, 5.1, 3.8, 4.8. But if we look at just a hot water run, if we go and have a look at that, 2.5, you can see there the blue line again. Whilst it is very jaggedy, it is a lot more consistent than it was. And there's, apart from the initial start where there's a drop, which is quite normal, that's probably where the three-port valve is opening and dumping in cooler water into the system before it rotates, circulates around and starts to be heated up. But the flow rate's a lot better. Flow rate's lower than the 20 litres per minute because I'm running the pump at 50% mode here to see if that also helps on the hot water run. So it is a lot better in terms of its performance, still a little bit erratic, which means there is still some air in the system which we need to get rid of. There's another run there on the 2nd of October, 2.1. So yeah, that's the update so far. So still work in progress. System's working really well. And the good thing is that the heat meter has helped us identify an issue with the trapped air in the system, which we wouldn't have known about if we'd just used the controls and the mechanisms that are supplied with the heat pump. So it does allow you to actually identify additional problems which you would have been blind to. So there you go. Any questions, give us a shout. I'll pick them up in the comments and I'll see you on the next video. All right, take care. Bye.